is Sean Edwards. I'm from northern New Mexico, and I'm 59 years old. I've been working on the house for a year and a half, 2 years. Living here with Laura, it's been 6 months. This is our power. The water's off the roof. No septic tank on an outhouse. Yeah, we're off the grid. I like solitude, so this is how you do it.
My name is Sanad Wadsworth. I am from the Bronx in New York City, and I'm 25 years old. I get up really early in the morning. I fix some coffee. Then I start making my lunch for the day. So I grew up in the projects. My grandmother was a nurse at 1199 at Presbyterian, and she took care of us. Everybody wants to become an adult so fast when you're a kid. You're like, oh, I can't wait till I become an adult. Nobody's gonna tell me what to do. And then when you get there, you're like, well, now what am I gonna do? It's a realization that this is the real world and you gotta take care of yourself. And it's not that easy as everybody made it seem when you was a kid.
My name is Pedro Sanchez. I am from Mexico City and I am 36.
Me dedico a la arquitectura. Soy editor de una revista de lifestyle. Toco en mis ratos libres, es mi hobby. Y estoy incursionando en el mundo del arte.
Ahorita estoy pintando una de mis primeras ediciones. Es una pieza que se llama M-Face. Literal, dos puntos, una franja horizontal, y puede parecer una idea muy sencilla, muy simple, que dices, ah, yo también puedo hacer una carita con dos puntitos negros, pero hacerlo en ese formato y que a la gente le guste, eso es como parte del chiste y de la idea. Que tengas que convencer a la gente de que les guste o no. Simplemente te estás expresando y habrá alguien a quien le llame la atención.
Every time I have my Levi's on, I'm either bucking bell, chopping wood. That's my life. Sunrise to sunset. It's where I'm the happiest, I guess. When you wear something every day and every winter, and it becomes a good friend. And the Levi's label is a tradition. Shoot, this jacket it has another 20 years. It keeps you warm.
Mi chamarra Levi's la compré hace 15 años. Hay una anécdota muy... Fui a una fiesta, eso que llegas a la fiesta, te la quitas. No volví a ver a mi chamarra por 2 años. Y en otra fiesta se me ocurrió llegar con un amigo a preguntarle por qué no es una chamarra muy común. Entonces, la vi y le dije a mi amigo, ¿dónde compraste tu chamarra? Y me dijo, no, me la encontré en una fiesta. Y dije, ah, ¿qué crees? Que esa es mi chamarra. Entonces él, sin problemas, un amigo muy cercano, me dijo, toma tu chamarra, y jamás volví a perder esa chamarra.
Entre más uso mi chamarra, luce mejor. Es la prenda que sabes que ha estado ahí durante muchos años y que te va a durar otros tantos más. No se va a acabar.
When I got out of high school, I still didn't know what I wanted to do. At the age of 19, I was riding a train one day, and I saw an ad on the train, and it was for a woman that would like to get into construction union. It looked so interesting. I wasn't used to seeing women in construction.
On most jobs, there are about 20 to 25 women. That's a big deal in 2017. A lot of people don't think women are strong enough to do this. So when you're there and you're doing it, it's like, wow. If you are working and
anyone gets a rip on their pants, usually you have to go home because you don't really carry extra pairs of pants to work. I don't have to worry about that. My pants haven't ripped in 5 years. They haven't had a hole in them. They haven't had a tear in them. And I'm just thankful because that's hard to find, especially when you're doing active work all day.
Lo que más me motiva en la vida es esa sensación de estar lleno, de estar vivo en todo momento, de estar feliz. Finalmente, a lo que venimos, o creo que venimos a la vida, es a ser felices. Esa yo creo que sería como mi consejo a la gente joven, que hagan las cosas con muchísima pasión y que dejen el miedo atrás.
The reason I like my trade so much is because there's a lot of improv in it. There's no one way to do one thing. I'm living more than the American dream. I'm a rock star on the job. I'm thankful for the life that my job has provided for me. I'm not living paycheck to paycheck. I'm not struggling to survive. I got it all.
My first ball at the Galisteo Rodeo. When your adrenaline's pumping so hard and you hit the ground and you're on your feet going to the arena so the bull doesn't come after you and get you. My injury, my bull riding injury, it's bigger than you can ever imagine. 6 broken ribs, punctured lung, broken shoulder, front teeth knocked out. Because of my injury, I'm not the same man that I was, not even close, you know, physically and mentally. But at the same time, I'm a better man, I'm a better person, more compassionate, more feeling, more appreciative of every second of this life.